Hi, I'm Rongji. In today's video, I'll be introducing you to our PathWave Signal Generation software application, Advanced Waveform Utility. Can I use my own waveform with Keysight signal generators for signal generation? Can we do end-to-end calibration and apply corrections to my waveform? Can I customize my waveform? Can I generate the waveform with good performance of PAPR? Yes, we can meet your requirements. With the AWU application, you can generate multiple types of waveforms with Keysight signal generators, perform calibration and waveform correction to ensure measurement accuracy, combine multiple waveforms in frequency domain or time domain into a single waveform, and improve ACPR measurement by applying CFR to your waveform. Moreover, some basic features are available for free. Next, I will demonstrate the AWU essential features, which are available for free. Let's go to the AWU application. You can press this button to record the waveform, and press the Generate button to see the waveform graph. You can modify the resampling ratio to perform oversampling of your waveform when carrying out PADPD measurements. You can override the sample rate of your waveform, thus expanding the 5G signal spectrum by a factor of 100, making it an easy and efficient way to conduct 6G experiments. AWU offers you a range of waveform types, such as CSV format, which allows you to record a user-defined CSV file and generate the waveform. AWU supports multiple types of signal generators, which can be configured and connected to. Once configured, simply press Generate and Download button here to play the waveform on SG. AWU supports remote control through Skippy as well. You can check the Skippy command for each parameter, making it easy to program with Python. Next, I will show you how waveform correction can improve wideband EVM measurement through a calibration method. Before we start the demo, it is important to know that we offer three calibration methods. The first is channel equalization, which utilizes VSA digital demode measurements for flatness calibration. The second is multi-tone calibration, which is used with VSA channel quality measurement, and it is ideal for frequency band edge flatness calibration. The third is IQ calibration, which covers both channel flatness calibration and IQ imbalance calibration, and is specially designed for use with an external IQ modulator. Now we can start. Press the AWU application. Click on the top menu here. Select the instrument type we want. Then click into the hardware subpage and input your instrument's IP address. Click on the connect button. After a few seconds, it will show the instrument is connected. Now, go to the Waveform tab, record the waveform we want to use. Press the Generate and Download button. After a few seconds, in the VSA, we can observe that the constellation diagram is not clear, and the EVM result is about 11%. Let's click on Correction block and then on the Calibrate button. In the pop-up window, let's make sure to preserve the VSA state and select the multi-tone calibration method. We should also modify the calibration waveform sample rate to 16 gig samples per second. And the tone space, the number of tones, look good to me. So we'll leave them as is. Now we can click the Calibrate button, and the calibration process will start automatically with the VSA. After a few seconds, we can see the message that the calibration has been completed and the correction file has been applied and saved on our local drive. If we click on the message, we can see the detailed location of the correction file. Now, let's generate and download the waveform again. We can see that the constellation diagram for 64 QAM is much clearer now, and EVM has improved to 4.3%. Next, I will demonstrate how to generate this waveform utilizing the multi-carrier summing feature. In the carrier setup block, let's record the first carrier waveform, then press the plus button to add the second carrier and record its carrier waveform. Repeat this for the third, fourth, and so on. We can see that these blocks have been automatically added, and we can modify settings for each carrier. For demonstration purpose, let's record the setting file I prepared before. Now we can see that 12 carrier waveforms have been recorded. In the frequency offset block, I have modified each carrier as desired. The same actions can be done for the length adjustment and phase power blocks. Now we can generate the waveform. After a few seconds, let's click on the spectrum. We can see that 12 carriers we specified gap we want. Next, I will show you how to create a UWB burst sequence waveform using time segment feature. Now let's get started. Let's record the HRP UWB SP1 with a good CRC waveform in the first segment. Then press the plus button here to add a second segment and record the dirty signal waveform to it. Now let's press the generate button. After a few seconds, we can see that the UWB burst sequences with two segments has been generated. Next, I will demonstrate how to use CFR to improve the ACPR of your waveform during PA testing. In the CCDF curve here, we can see that the original waveform peak power is too high. Thus, let's click on the Crest Factor Reduction block and enable it. We can then set the target PAPR iteration number and add the filter mask. For example, for my 100 MHz 5G new radio signal, I will add the mask like this. After that, click the generate button. After a few seconds in the CCDF curve, we can see that the waveform's target PR is now close to 8 dB now. In summary, these basic features listed here are free to use for AWU Essential. However, I highly recommend upgrading the license to Premium. As with advanced features, you can make more accurate measurements. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website. Thank you for watching.